أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِعَادٍ. Didn't you already see how your Lord did, how your Lord dealt with the nation of Ad, with the group called Ad? In the previous surah, Allah had tried to warn the disbelievers by means of warning them about the next life. From the very beginning, هَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ الْغَاشِيَةِ وُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ خَاشِعَةٌ عَامِلَةٌ نَاصِبَةٌ تَصْلَى نَارًا حَامِيَةٌ تُسْقَى مِنْ عَيْنٍ آنِيَةٍ لَيْسَ لَهُمْ طَعَامٌ إِلَّا مِنْ ضَرِيَّةٍ لَا يُسْمِنُ وَلَا يُغْنِي مِنْ جُوعٍ. That entire passage is warnings to those who don't believe about what is going to come on the last day. That's in the previous surah. So obviously they're not afraid of that warning. So the only thing left to do is, if they don't believe in the unseen, maybe they can be given a warning from what they can actually see. What is it that they can actually see? They can see the ruins of the nations that they pass by all the time. If you're not willing to think about these oaths, and you're not willing to think about what is ahead of you, at least think about what happened yesterday, what happened before you. So we find, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِعَادٍ. Now in this surah we find, did you not already see, and of course the wording here is to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, didn't you see? And when Allah speaks to His Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, the Messenger recites it. So who also is listening? Everybody's listening, right? The entire audience, and at that time even the disbelievers are listening. So though Allah is talking to the Messenger, don't think the audience is limited to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because his job is يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ. He recites unto them the ayat. So they're listening too. So Allah is talking to him, but they're supposed to be listening, and they're, what's going on in their minds. أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِعَادٍ. Didn't you already see how your Lord did, how your Lord dealt with the nation of Ad, with the group called Ad? A couple of things here. The word tara, didn't you see? Previous surah also told us to look at something. Afala yanzuruna ila al-ibli kayfa khuliqat wa ila as-sama'i kayfa rufi'at. Didn't they stare at the camel, and didn't they stare at the sky, and didn't they stare at the mountain, and didn't they stare at the earth? They were asked to stare. Nazara in Arabic, yanzuruna in the previous surah is to stare. And it's to stare, like pay attention to something and think about it deeply as you are looking at it. But ra'a, alam tara, it's a different word for seeing. And this is what you're not going to see in translation. You'll see, don't they see the camel? Didn't you see what happened? So you'll see the English word see, and you won't tell what the difference is. But here a different word, ru'ya, is used. And tara in Arabic is used for something that you don't necessarily see with your eyes, but you know how when you think about something deeply and you say, I see what you're saying, right? Or I see, what does that mean? I understand. Or I finally see what he means. You don't see what he means, you understand what he means. But what do you say? I see what he means. You understand? So that meaning of ru'ya is understood here. This is why it's from the af'alul qulub according to the Arabs. This is from the verbs of the heart. What they mean by that is, it's not a physical action, it's an action that takes place in the heart and in the mind. Right? So didn't you think about, is what it's saying. Didn't you reflect upon how your Lord dealt with Ad? Now Allah didn't say what he did to them. Allah didn't say, didn't you see what your Lord did to them? Didn't you see what happened to them? Allah says, how? The question is not, ماذا فعل ربك? It is, كيف فعل ربك? How did he do it to them? The word how is really important. Because this nation of Ad, that Allah is about to talk about and tell us more about, you should know something about them. They're a very powerful nation. They were known for building enormous beams and pillars in construction. These are people that their people themselves were called ذُلْ عِمَاد. They're features of beams and pillars themselves, meaning they're very, very tall. Nobody goes into battle with them because they're very, like genetically, they're pretty strong people. And Allah Azza wa Jal, you know, comments on their strength like that. So, إِرَمَ ذَاتِ الْعِمَادِ الَّتِي لَمْ يُخْلَقْ مِثْلُهَا فِي الْبِلَادِ. We'll come to those ayat. But you know, those nations that built these amazing monuments and were so powerful and undefeatable, when the Arabs would pass by the neighboring towns, they would see the ruins of these towns, right? The question would come to mind, they were so powerful, not what happened, but how could they be destroyed? The first question that comes is, these people were so powerful, how is it possible that they were overcome? Who overcame them? These were the people who used to say, you know, is there anyone stronger than us? Is there anyone that has more power than we do? So Allah asks them, His Messenger, to reflect, alayhi salatu wasalam, how your Lord dealt with Ad. Now in this there are two things. One, there is an encouragement to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How is it encouragement? You think these Quraysh are powerful? You think they have a lot of power and they can oppress the believers whenever they want? We read about that in Surah Al-Buruj. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَتَنُوا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَتُوبُوا. You think they can just oppress and get away? There were people much more powerful than them. You see how they were dealt with? So don't worry about it. Allah has power to control them. That's one thing. On the other hand, it is a threat being issued to the kuffar. So the same statement is consolation to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and at the same time it is a threat to the disbelievers. Interestingly enough, in the previous surah, Allah commanded His Messenger to remind others. فَذَكِّرْ. Remind. And in this surah, Allah is reminding His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam when He says, أَلَمْ تَرَى. Didn't you see? And you know, the wording is interesting because this is the last time in the Qur'an we're going to find the mention of Ad. In the coming surahs, until the end of the Mus'haf, there is no more mention of Ad. So has Ad been mentioned many times before? Sure. So at the end of that discussion, like a teacher telling the student, didn't you see? Haven't you already thought about this? Haven't I told you so much about this already? You understand? So it's this culminating statement about these destroyed nations that is coming so eloquently in this surah. أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِعَادٍ. You know, in the previous surah, Allah told us, فَيُعَذِّبُهُ اللَّهُ الْعَذَابَ الْأَكْبَرُ. Whoever turns away and disbelieves, Allah will punish them and destroy them. And now don't only think about how He will destroy them. Here's an example how He already destroyed them. Look not just to the future, but also to the past. Let's see. They used to say, by the way, just some things about Ad if you don't already know. They were a nation that were the third or fourth generation after Nuh alayhi salam, according to Qatada radiallahu anhu. These are people from Yemen. The messenger sent to them was Hud alayhi salam. And their famous arrogant statement was, Man ashaddu minna quwwa. It's going to sound very familiar when I translate it for you. Who is more powerful than us? Who has the military capacity that we do? Who's going to take us on? We're number one. Man ashaddu minna quwwa. That was their arrogant statement. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah says, Wa ha'ula al-'ad al-ula wa hum alladhina ba'atha Allahu fihim rasulahu Hud. You know, these are the first Ad, and these are the people that Allah sent His Messenger Hud to. فَكَذَّبُوهُ وَخَالَفُوهُ. They lied against Him and they opposed Him. وَكَانُوا عُتَاتْ مُتَمَرِّدِينَ جَبَّارِينَ خَارِجِينَ عَنْ طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ مُكَذِّبِينَ لِرُسُلِهِ. These were people arrogant, hurting others, engaged in all sorts of rebellion, and the biggest crime, they lied against the messengers Allah sent to them. فَذَكَرَ تَعَالَى كَيْفَ أَهْلَكَهُمْ وَدَمَّرَهُمْ. Then Allah mentioned, how did He destroy even them? And how did He even crush the likes of them? وَجَعَلَهُمْ أَحَادِيثَ وَعِبْرَةً. And He turned them into nothing but news to talk about. They're just like a shocking thing. Did you remember how that happened? And عِبْرَةً, meaning people pass by their towns and they get scared just looking at them. But now Allah's going to answer another question without asking it. Why did Allah destroy them? Why did Allah destroy these nations? أَلَّذِينَ طَغَوْا فِي الْبِلَادِ. Those were the ones that had rebelled. Tagha. Tagha means to go beyond your limits with an urge to rebel against someone. You know, there's one thing to break the rules because you were desperate. You broke the rules, you feel bad about it. Then there's you broke the rules because you were in an act of defiance against the authority. This is tughyan, right? الَّذِينَ طَغَوْا فِي الْبِلَادِ. You know, who is this rebellion against? Think about that. This rebellion is, of course, against Allah Himself, against His messengers. His messengers who didn't have any armies behind them. All they had was words of warning. So it's easy to rebel against them. Oh, your Lord doesn't want us to do that, right? Oh, don't kill the camel? Okay, yeah. And then they'll kill the camel. And laugh about it too. The she-camel, right? That's how they'll do things. So the idea was, we're going to rebel and we're going to make a mockery of the guidelines and the instructions that have been placed before us because we feel like we have the power to do so. What are you going to do about it? Right, what are you going to do? This idea of we have the muscle, we can do whatever we want. This is what led them to their destruction. So Allah said, أَلَّذِينَ طَغَوْا. Now I said, this rebellion of course is against the messengers, and by rebelling against the messengers, you're really rebelling against Allah.